So I've made several videos in the last couple of days talking about Liverpool's midfield targets. I've mentioned the likes of Kefren Thuram. I made an entire video on Alexis McAllister. I've also spoken about the likes of James Ward-Prowse and Manu Kone too. But there has been one target who's come up recently who I am extremely interested in. And yes, it's another Eredivisie baller. Orkan Kürkçü, a Turkish international from Feyenoord, is the latest midfielder to be linked to Anfield. So who is he? What sort of midfielder is he? And how can he impact this Liverpool team? I'm Chris Stonage. This is the Stonage Channel. And let's get into it. Now, Orkan Kürkçü is 22 years old and has recently won the Eredivisie with the underdogs, Feyenoord. It's fair to say that PSV and Ajax usually have the stronghold on the Eredivisie, but Feyenoord have come through and won it in 2023. And the 22-year-old, despite being so young, has such a vast wealth of experience behind him. And the Turkish international has made it clear that he wants to leave the club this summer. This quote via Fabrizio Romano says, "I've got a good relationship with the manager, Arne Slot, who has been linked with a move to the Premier League also. But in the case a bid arrived from the right club, I would be ready to take the next step in my career." For such a young age, he has a real wealth of experience, which includes 20 international caps for Turkey and the captain and leader of Feyenoord's successful European campaigns, reaching the final of the Europa Conference League last season and the semi-final of the Europa League this season. He's an exceptional passer of the ball and a specialist from long range, something that one would say Liverpool have lacked. Apart from the, Trent Alexander-Arnold and the most exceptional passer of the ball probably in the league, Liverpool have lacked this sort of demonstrably powerful midfielder. You can certainly understand why teams such as Manchester United, Arsenal and Inter Milan have been linked with Kürkçü in recent weeks because of his incredible football reference profile. Oh my God, there's so many 99s. Well, not just 99s, just lots of greens in general. There's the 99th for progressive passes. Now, this is something I made very, very clear in the Alexis McAllister video that I think Liverpool will be looking at as a progressive midfielder. Not someone who's potentially a protector like a Fabinho or a Henderson, but someone who can bring the ball forward, like a prime Oxlade-Chamberlain, shall we say. 99th percentile for passes attempted and progressive passes. 99th for shot-creating actions. 97th for total shots. 95th for non-penalty goals as well. So Kürkçü has so much ability in the final third. In general, he scored 12 goals and got 5 assists in all competitions this season, which is fantastic from midfield. They are impressive stats, but of course it is the Eredivisie, but we've just seen what Cody Gakpo can do as well. In terms of weaknesses, I said this about Alexis McAllister too. It's a worry about his physicality for me. He's not particularly explosive. He's not particularly strong. He's more of a creative driver of him in the midfield. I'd say sort of like Mason Mount when he was playing really well in that 8 for Chelsea under Frank Lampard and then subsequently Thomas Tuchel, who then moved him out to the left and sort of disrupted the progress of Mason Mount. That is the sort of player I would describe Kürkçü as. He's got 2 years left on his contract. So in terms of is this transfer realistic, I would say so. If they don't sell him this summer, Feyenoord, for a good price, they'll let him go for probably cheaper next season because they're going to have to accept it because he's only got a year left on his contract. He only earns €320,000 a year, which comes to about €6,000 a week, which means that even if Liverpool pay him, say, £40,000 or £50,000 a week, which is a very, very small and paltry amount in comparison to the big earners, Thiago, say, on £200,000 a week, Van Dijk, Salah, on crazy amounts of money in comparison to this, it will still be seen as a massive upgrade for Orkan Kürkçü. The price tag, I would say, would be around £30 to £35 million. He's certainly someone who has taken the eye of a lot of elite European clubs. And I think that is somewhere where Liverpool will look to the ballpark Liverpool usually try and sign players in. Think your Jotters, think your Salahs, think your Manes, think your Fabinhos, think your Thiagos even, who's slightly less than that. Think your Canates, that sort of area, between £30 and £40 million, which I would say now it's below average in the top elite level in terms of price tags for players. A lot of clubs are looking towards £60 and £70 million. If Liverpool can get a player like Kürkçü in for £30 to £35 million, yes, it might be a little bit of a risk because he's coming from a lower league, but there's someone there at 22 years old, the same age as Curtis Jones, who could improve and vastly take up his stocks in the Premier League. Liverpool do need midfield additions. I mean, it sounds like Groundhog Day, but Jordan Henderson, Fabinho aren't, in my opinion, good enough long-term anymore. Thiago has just a year left on his contract. Will he renew or will he be let go at the end of this season? I think he will be let go because realistically, who's going to come in and pay an amount that he couldn't replicate in value throughout this season? Curtis Jones is still young, but has come in and done really, really well. Harvey Elliott's done really well too. Carvalho will probably go out on loan, but then they've lost Keita, Milner, Oxlade-Chamberlain too. There's a real void in that midfield, and Liverpool need to get bodies in, whether it be two or three. Obviously, Bajcetic is coming back into the fold from injury. Tyler Morton's coming back from Blackburn too. But realistically, we're looking at three midfielders, okay? Got to say £100 million, £35 million. That's basically a third of it. And then you look across to the two Rams and the Konés of this world. And yeah, for me, I think this is almost a no-brainer for Liverpool. The only thing that worries me is the character element. So Erkan Kurkcu has had several run-ins when it comes to the likes of pride flags and something that Liverpool vehemently support. Obviously, everyone is entitled to their beliefs, but I personally feel like you should be able to love who you want and not be judged for it. But then also you have the right to not promote whatever you think. So in terms of footballing ability, he's a perfect fit. Of course, Liverpool do recruit on character too. I'm not saying he's a bad person, but it certainly would make an imprint on me. If I was to say, it wouldn't make me take a second look and think and wonder whether he's the sort of person that we'd want around. Of course, it's his own beliefs and I don't want to alienate anybody with that, but realistically for me, it is important that we have players who are openly supportive of things like this. So in terms of style, in terms of guile, in terms of position, I think we're pretty much bang on with Erkan Kurkcu. It's whether Jurgen Klopp will look to sanction that £35 million. And for me, football-wise, it's a complete no-brainer. Let me know what you think, and I want to hear everyone. I want to hear polite debate in the comments below as well, if possible. And yeah, we will catch you in the next video where we'll be talking about some more Liverpool transfers as well as maybe some other clubs. Let me know what other players you'd like me to analyse and see whether they'd be a good fit. We'll catch you in the next one. See you later. Bye-bye.